Here we go, go, go. We are back, back, back with Pretty Liars, season 6, episode 1, and I'm Shelos. And this is episode 1 of Game on Charles. They show what happened with last season when the girls got trapped in Charles' little dollhouse. And they finally realized that they're fenced in electronically, and Charles locked them outside. Spencer tells how close she was to Charles and how, like, it's a weird feeling, like, she feels like, you don't know who that person is, but you feel like it's family, but it's not family. But to Spencer, if Charles is a delinquent, then it is family. Point blank, it is family. To her, because she is the stepsister of Jason and Allison. Girls got locked outside, I think, because either Hannah yelled at Charles and all this other stuff. So they ended up sleeping outside all day and all night. Rain through the cold night, where they looked like they had, where there was no water and no food for them, because if you were in the house, you got fed. Unless you were in the hole. The door finally opens. The girls walk down the pathway, and Mona gets taken away. After, you know, he gasses the girls and all this other stuff. The girls are left on that little flat cold table, you know, that usually is put into the morgue in the hospital. The slab, and it's usually with dead people on there. Usually. She goes back to her reset mode of being Allie. Even though she knows she's Mona, she's going, but she has to go back to Allie because she has to play by Charles' rules and all the other stuff. Mona wants the girls to go back to the room after the three charms go off. So they get a surprise on them and they basically get punished. So you hear some screaming and all the stuff, like, stop, don't touch me, blah, 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 this and that, all that. And then they get turned back into their old selves from season 1. Arya with the pink hair, Spencer dressed as a preppy chick, like really preppy. Emily back into her sports gear, like sporty stuff. And Hannah dressed back into when she was hanging out with Mona. Even though she's still kind of dressed that way. Allie is out of jail because they overturned her case because she didn't kill Mona. The police and stuff are looking for Andrew Campbell, Arya's wife, Arya's little blue thing. And expect him to be dangerous because they found evidence and stuff saying that Charles was always stuck with girls and all that stuff. If you think about it, Andrew wasn't really around in the episodes. I mean, he was friends with Spencer. Helped Spencer out. I mean, he kissed Arya, started dating Arya. Emily knows him. But I don't know. I don't know. Or Mr. Charles is trying to pin it on Andrew. Maybe. Let's see. Caleb and Angela are watching Allie do the statement, and Tanner thinks it's Andrew, and the police are working with Allie to capture Andrew. Another girl is dressed as Mona was dressed. Mona gives the girls food. Jason almost gets shot because he decided to be discreet and come through the garage, like the people told him to be. A song plays in the background, and Allie talks to the person calling her. And find out that the caller is in the house. Police checks the house with a fake A. Hannah and Toby hear this phone call that had pigs. So Allie pretty much found a way to sneak out and meet up with Ezra and Caleb. Toby finally told Tana that it could be the Campbell's apple farm. Pig meaning farm, and son the apple tree or something like that. What was the song? I don't remember. We find out that Caleb and Ezra were the one giving the calls. Caleb gives some shoes to Allie to track her down and all this other stuff. The girls have to go into Allie's room for an arrival, and they are dressed in their own clothes. Like I said, the girls are shooken up still from whatever happened to them, because we don't know. There are boxes on the bed, and it's Allie's stuff from her room. So they realize that Allie is being delivered here. So they realize that Charles is setting them up to all be here, to be all of his dolls and stuff. Yeah, dolls, darling, dolls. where was I? Mono's left up in the hall. Spencer sees a toy that's initial CD, meaning most likely Charles DeLorean is. Arya finds Mona wrote a note that Charles is gonna kill her. So, you know, she called Spencer, not Hannah, because Hannah would have freaked out and yelled at Charles and the camera for no reason. When you can't really do anything if you don't know who he is in person. I mean, kinda seen him, but you don't really know who he is. Allie wants to kiss her and hear music from where a car is parked, and the driver and goes in the car and drives it and goes wherever the GPS tells her to go. The girls are the same stuff that they lost from their house and stuff, and then an article about their parents, and then Hannah's mom gets sent to the hospital because she's physically sick, that she thinks that her daughter is gone. Like, Spencer takes the Etch a Sketch and tells that Charles is a Delorentist. Allie drives Tyler to Tyler State Park, and the car seems to know who she is. Most likely it's probably Charles telling her to take the stuff in the back to help her with her car, and then there was a card in there saying they put on everything and whatever. Which is what Ezra and Caleb found. And Caleb and them found the boots, and how Allie placed them that like that for a reason, for them to follow her. Toby tells Tana where the car is, and they had to put her, yeah. And they're gonna go find her. The girls find the vent and find the room where personal stuff of Charles is. He finds Allie on the camera, knowing that she's heading to his trap. And Spencer decides to torch the film. While torching the film, Ariel was like, torch the place. So, to get back at Charles, they're gonna torch everything of his. Since you decided to take everything in and chop them in here like they're fucking dolls, you're gonna get your stuff torched. Your soul toys, sorry. Which I know further down the line it's gonna, you shouldn't have done that, girls, but you know, in order to get out of here, you gotta do what's necessary, right? Right. So, when Emily and them tried to stop the fire because they didn't want to get burnt inside, she pulled out the curtain and sees Charles behind this glass, like, literally staring at them. That kind of freaked me out. I was like, God, like, why is he just sitting there? I was like, don't be standing there. So, he decides to turn on the fire alarm. The girls go try to find Mona, which they find out that she was in the hole. They didn't know Sarah Harvey was in there, which I'll get into. Caleb and Ezra, they find Allie and the girls, so they walk away. Like I said, the girls try to set the fire, and when Ellie heard the fire alarm from underground. He realized that it was a fire himself. So they end up finding each other when the police come. They all go to the individual lovers and whatnot. Okay, so I'm back. Where'd Ellie go? They all find each other, and the police find another girl named Sarah Harvey, which, you know, I think either season 3 or 4, maybe somewhere down the line, they were still calling Ellie. Emily meets Sarah Harvey's friend. And Emily asks Ellie who Charlton Lawrence is, and that's what they left up with the episode. Pretty much what he left off at. That's what you want to go at. Really. Really. Thank you. Thank you for that episode. Thank you for leaving us off there. I don't think Alan really knows because she was a baby. Maybe she might remember. And again, she might just go around until the girls are out anyway. But as far as we know, the girls are out. But Charles, it's not just for the girls.